What's up, guys? So another video here for you guys. I am super pumped about this one. It came out really dope. I am excited. What we're doing here is pretty much a pompadour with a hard part and a mid-low skin fade on the sides. I apologize because I actually hit the record button a little too late, and so I missed the 000 guideline that I put around his head already. So here I am starting out with my number two guard, pretty much just laying a foundation for my fade and also scooping out and helping me create that foundation on the transition here. So not only is it helping me with my fade, but it's also going to help me later on with my transition here when I blend everything together. For some reason, my magic clippers are catching the hair, and so I keep going back and forth with my seniors. Here, I am setting my second guideline with the lever open. I am making sure that I am following my guideline and just stretching a little bit at the back of the head. So the bottom line that I set with the 000, I am knocking down that line with the lever halfway closed or halfway open, whichever you prefer to say it. So I open up the lever and with my number one guard, and I am moving up another inch or so, creating another guideline. I'm doing a little bit of scooping action here too, just because it helps me transition from that 1.5 to the two guard that I had set there before. Number one guard open. Now I am closing my number one guard, and I am knocking down that line between the half and the one guard open. I am working on that line pretty hard. So after I did that all around the head, I come back with my number 1.5 guard. So the 1.5 with the one guard lever open is a little bit smaller than the actual 1.5 guard. So the 1.5 guard is really just to smooth things out, just literally smoothing things out. As you can see here, the 1.5 guard, I am doing a little bit of flicking action and just smoothing the transition out. With my Slimline Pros, I am going over that 000 area that I took down. That creates another layer in transition. And then after that, I take my 5-star shaver, go right underneath that Slimline Pro. So I am not going all the way up to the line. I'm leaving little transitions area between the 000, the Slimline Pros, and the 5-star senior, just to create a better transition. So as you see here now, I am just detailing, just straight up detailing, like using the 1/16th guard, trying to make this thing just smooth as possible. Doing a little clipper of a comb, using my JRL brand new clipper I just got recently. They're super cool, but they're not the best fading clippers, so I just use them for bulk removal and clipper of a comb action. That's what I use. So here with the clipper of a comb, I am literally just taking out all those extra hairs that may stick out or not. Here, as you can see, there's a hard line there. The camera angle doesn't help either, but there is a little bit of a line there. So here I'm just detailing it, just making sure everything is nice and smooth and everything. But now I have my thinning shears and I am softening that transition here in the middle. It looks like there is a harder line than what actually was there, just because of the angle of the camera. With the thinning shears, it's simple. You have to be careful though, because I have two different types of thinning shears and one of them actually removes a lot of hair. This one is a Japanese thinning shears that I got off of Amazon. They're great because they remove very little hair, and so the safest thing you can do, the safest way you can ever blend hair is with those thinning shears. So now I'm wetting the hair just a little bit to do a little bit of blending with my scissors over fingers. What I do, if the client wants a haircut that requires a comb over to a specific side, I start the process on the side that the hair falls towards to. So in this case, he wants his hair combed over to the right. So what I do is I start blending the sides first and then I work my way around it. So that gives me my guideline to even everything out. It's a very simple process, but it takes a little while to get used to. You know, it's weird. It's one of those things where it's very easy, but not simple to do. So Now I'm just going over and doing the little shape up around the head and the hairlines. Now I am going over with my Slimline Pros and creating that hard line. I try to stay away from very thick hard lines. A hard line should be minimal and thin, and I do not go far back into the head. Now here with the razor, I'm just detailing every little line. I am going over with my razor, straight razor, just going over with the lines, shaping him up, making the haircut pop and everything. I don't like to use any shaving gels or liquid or any kind of shaving product when I'm doing the shape up. For some reason, I find it to be more accurate when you do a shape up on dry skin. You just have to be a little more careful when you do that so you don't cut the client and everything. But for the most part, I like shaping up the clients on dry skin. Now I'm doing the hard part. I did wet the hard part a little bit. Up there is a little more rough, so you can't really use a razor up there without any kind of lubrication. So I use a little bit of water and rub it up against the skin, and then I go ahead and razor that line in. Let's begin the styling. I wet the hair a little bit. I actually wet the hair a lot bit. When you blow dry it, you want to start from the back, especially if you're doing something like a pompadour. You want to start from the back. That's going to create the foundation of where the bangs are going to sit on. Here with a little bit of twisting with the comb, I am lifting the hair up and using the blow dryer to lift the hair up. And I am working my way up to the front until I reach the bangs. So once I have the bangs here, I am just picking up the hair just to get a lot of volume. Pompadours, obviously you need volume. And so this comb action creates that volume. The client actually came in with his own hair product he bought somewhere in the pharmacy or something like that. So it's a natural finish, kind of a wax thing. First I apply it on my hands, rub it, get some heat going on. Use my fingers to run across the, you know, over the head, and then slowly work my way and just comb the hair back and forth just to evenly spread the product. Here it is, guys. This is the haircut. The client loved it. He really loved it. So if he loves it, then I love it. And that's that. Thanks for watching again. Any questions, any comments, if any of you are barbers and have any tips for me, please leave a comment below. I will greatly appreciate it. I am still learning. Thank you so much, and don't forget to subscribe. Peace.